main reason I want him to present it tonight is before he goes out to the whole public, I think the one of the foremost groups that he has to hear this is labor. Because so many of your locals represent government workers, the state, or county and the city levels. So I think it was very important to get this to you first before it goes really public. And I wanted you to get the opportunity to ask questions. So really, what I really wanted to hear, because everybody's gonna hear what they wanna hear out there. There's gonna be people that say, oh, I hear economic opportunity. Some people say, oh, I hear my taxes can be lower. They're gonna have different reasons why they're gonna vote which way they go. But I think it's important to get the feedback from labor, and I'm not the only voice here. And I think it's, you're the voice, and that's what needs to be heard tonight. Warren?
Yeah, I have a lot about this commission, first time I'm really hearing it about. So a couple of very basic questions. Who chartered the consensus commission?
So the commission was actually chartered via a resolution, two resolutions of the City Common Council and the county legislature. County Leg back in March of 2014 voted 17-0 via resolution to empower the commission to do this work. City Council voted at, I think it was an 8-1 vote to do that. The resources of Syracuse 2020 and Center State, as well as our other partners, have been used to put that commission together, and ultimately the staff, the group. And as you saw, we also had engagement and involvement at the very beginning from the town supervisors and the village mayors as well.
So will the final recommendation be made to those people who charted you?
Yes, but I think more broadly, frankly, we're making the recommendations to the community as a whole. So yes, the county, yes, the city, yes, the council, yes, the legislature, the towns and the villages, but frankly, you know, this is an issue that transcends, I think, our elected officials. Absolutely, they have to be engaged, and they have been engaged in that process. But it's an issue that touches each and every one of us in this room and beyond in meaningful ways. We're all property taxpayers, we're all residents, we're all, you know, parents or whatnot, and we're all looking to try to build our community. We did not want to have this conversation, as has happened in some other places, behind closed doors. Many of you may have heard about the sort of Buffalo effort to do some government consolidation or whatever it was that they called it. I don't know, it was probably, what, a decade ago? Uh-huh. 8 years ago?
Yeah.
And they had like six leaders sitting in a room for 6 months making all sorts of decisions, and they rolled it out to the community. People were like, what is this? We never even heard of it. So the goal from the beginning has been to take the facts, the baseline, the options, and then the recommendations, take that directly to the people of the county and the city and the towns and the villages, and make sure that that dialogue isn't happening in a vacuum.
Well, I'm just curious, and what authority do the recommendations have? Do they have any authority whatsoever?
Candidly, they only have the authority that you and the elected officials put behind them. Right?
One real quick question. Indianapolis and Louisville, in the items there, doesn't indicate whether the mean income rose as economic development increased in those communities. Do you know if the actual median income did rise?
I do not have that answer off at my fingertips. We have that information somewhere, but I don't have it. But we will circle back and get that back to you. It's a great question.
That is good.
You know, and one of the things I would say in response to that question, I think Murph and I certainly, but I think I'm not going out on a limb by speaking for the commission members. Our goal in launching this has been to try to build an economy that works for everyone, right? Median income and income levels in Central New York have also stagnated, yeah. Just like jobs
population,
and just
jobs.
Like population. Figuring out how to get all those indicators moving in the right direction at the same time, I think, is one of the biggest challenges we have.
Your number one goal right now is to get a referendum on the ballot in November. That's the first thing you're shooting for?
No, the number one goal right now is to get this information out on January 26th and to make sure that as many people in this community hear about it and are engaged in that process over the course of the following 45 days. I'll be very clear about this for everybody here. There is no set of secret recommendations. There are no decisions that made. Dr. Nave is on the commission. He knows this. There is no decisions that have been made about what those final recommendations will even be, let alone about what might be done with those recommendations down the road. issue of a referendum is something that's been talked about, because if there were to be a decision and an interest from elected leaders and or the community at large to merge or consolidate or do any sort of broad-based integration of one or more municipal entities, the voters have to be involved. And frankly, on a decision of that scale, you would want them to be involved. You wouldn't want that to be something that people could do without, you know, talking to their constituents.
I came tonight thinking that this was mainly about the merger of Syracuse and the county, and I often did wonder why they want other things to merge, like the villages. So now it sounds to me like you're really looking at combining not just the city and county, but possibly the villages and other municipalities joining in to a larger consolidation.
I think that there are some opportunities that some people believe exist in, you know, in service delivery across all of the structure. Absolutely. Do I think that everybody is ready to recommend the consolidation or merger of everybody? No. I think that everybody wants to hear whatever all of those entities think once they see all of our data and see some of the stuff that we looked at and that was told to us and shared with us over the last 6 months. And I think there's lots of opportunities for conversation. It is not, I can say officially, about the city and just the city, just the county, just anybody. The whole idea when everybody sat together at the very beginning and Dennis was there was we are all in this together. Now, this isn't some of us or those of us. This is all of us. This is where we all love to live and work and play. So let's look at it for all of us.
Yeah, I would offer even, you know, maybe going a step further. If when these options are presented next week and when those, if and when those sort of morph into final recommendations, I think it's safe to say that those options and ultimately those recommendations are going to require or going to add to the point about, you know, what force of law do they have. They're going to ask and they're going to challenge our communities at every level of government to change, right? For the very reason that you saw in the, you know, some of the data on the baseline report. Like, we can do better than 36 individual municipalities each doing their own, you know, tax assessment or each doing their own, you know, whatever that may be. We can definitely do better than that. We're all, it's difficult, but there's no doubt that we can do better. So there is going to be a request and a challenge to every level of government to change. What's requested of which levels, I think, is still an open-ended question and one of the things we're looking for feedback on. And candidly, I just want to be very clear. There is not a, there is no way to do this from the top down, right? This is not trying to force any municipality to be a part of something. The only way that any structural change happens is if voters in the community see a benefit from it. They believe in the economic opportunity of following in the footsteps of other communities, and they're the ones that ask for it. If they don't ask for it, then there's no structural change that's going to come.